All right, ladies and gentlemen, tonight we are here in West Fargo, North Dakota, racing at the Red River Valley Speedway. Welcome back to today's video. Of course, another night of action with the World of Outlaws Sprint Car Series for the Shark Racing number 1T. Now, I'm super excited to run this place for the first time. Now, one thing I kind of found funny on video, the track looks pretty big, and I think it's just how wide it is. It really is wide, bottom to top, with really solid progressive banking all the way to the edge. But in person, it actually looks much smaller, and it almost is like a D shape. The back straightaway seems a little bit shorter than the front stretch, and it's almost like you never really stop turning. And typically, from what I've seen, just really wide and slick, and you're either all the way up here or you're all the way down there. Which makes me excited, and I'm hoping we can see that later this evening. Now, as far as the Shark Racing 1T, my crew, they have been working hard since the early morning hours just to get our equipment turned back around. Unfortunately, they had to do some swapping around and some tearing apart of the car and then getting the car from upstairs down so we can run. Can't thank them enough for that. Unfortunately, my stupid mistake caused some of that extra work, and that's how it goes. So that's behind us. Today's a new day, ready to get after it here at Red River Valley. In just a little bit, we'll have the pit meeting, and then roll right into engine heat, hot laps, and the most important part to start the show, single car qualifying. So our night began in normal fashion. We're getting ready to go. I get in the car for engine heat, and when I push over and they go to fire me, the car would not fire. So we tried multiple times. Started scrambling, came back to the trailer, started changing things, and nothing unfortunately would work, so we had to start swapping engines.
They've got the new power plant under the hood, but it sounds like there still may be an issue for Tanner Holmes in the 1T. So Tanner Holmes coasting to a stop in turn number one, and the Shark Racing 1T headed back to the pit area. Looks like Tanner Holmes making it back onto the speedway in the Shark Racing number 1T. That's the Pels Tire Service, low E-reflective insulation, Newman's Racing engine, Shark Racing entry. One lap and one lap only for Tanner Holmes. Missed his spot in the qualifying order. Best he scored would be 15th no matter what lap time he turns. And his official lap time is a 12.779, 12.779, 25th quickest for the 1T of Tanner Holmes.
Well, tonight, ladies and gentlemen, it has kind of turned into a complete disaster to start. I don't know what else really to say. So, like I told you guys earlier, had to do some swapping around after yesterday. So, got the car all finished up, right? Went to fire up for engine heat and literally did not run, would not fire. We tried to start it multiple times. We thought maybe I wasn't getting pushed fast enough, or maybe it took a second for fuel, you know, being in the new car, and did not fire. Brought it back here to the trailer, changed some stuff, went and tried to fire again, still didn't fire. Tried again, didn't fire. Just double checking everything, put new plugs in, didn't fire. And then ended up like, all right, we can't try anything else. We needed to swap engines. Did a great job, you know, actually made it to our spot for qualifying and went to fire, and you know, 410 aluminum block, I just kind of, when they don't have any heat, they're not going to run. We were going to try to attempt to run a lap. I said, you guys want me to run a lap? Of course, but you know, the engine not having any heat, that's not the greatest, which it wouldn't run anyway. But they pushed me back to the pits. We let it warm up. We got one lap there at the end, which the rule with the one lap at the end is, I think, you can't be better than half of the field. And we went out late anyway, and the track I think was starting to get, you know, slower and slower, and anyway we were like 23rd or 22nd. So it's how it goes. It's one of those nights, you know. This is how the tour can be. You have something where all of a sudden you're chasing, trying to find one problem right before it's time to go, and just like I said, that's kind of how the last 30 minutes have been here in the pit area. And so all you can do is now put that behind us and go into the heat race. Engine ran. I literally got like one lap, and that was my first lap around the track. If I could do it again, I would have been a little lower in one and two and a little higher in three and four. I just got caught in the wrong spots, but not really even sure car felt. I mean, it felt okay for a lap, but anyway, we're gonna move into a heat race. We're gonna be starting deep. We went forward there in that heat race, started ninth and finished seventh. Part of, you know, some of the chaos tonight, which makes things difficult, is I didn't really get to watch where guys were running and qualifying before I went out. Like, I was trying to watch on Dirt Vision last second, throwing the phone out the window to go qualify, and then I ended up in the first heat there, so I didn't get to maybe watch a heat race before, see how the track was racing. So you're basically as green on a place you've never been to before in race mode with a pretty good heat. Started ninth though, passed two cars, so that's gonna help us now start farther up in the B. Should be rolling off, I think, from third or fourth. That'll be up next. Car felt okay. That's also part of it, is we lost that time to maybe see where our car was and how we could make it better. Right now, the track, it's weird. It looks like it has some grip, but it's almost like it's slimy in some spots. It's really hard in others. And a lot of guys, it just feels like you're on the gas, but you're not going anywhere. You're just spinning the tires, but you almost have to, because if you lift, you're gonna go slower. You're just almost trying to spin through it, if that makes sense, and keep carrying momentum. So we'll kind of go up and watch this last heat, but overall, you know, I think we can make some changes and just be a little bit better. Feel a little bit more on the free side, but not like crazy free spinning out. Just need a little bit more feel in the car and feel the right rear a little bit more. So we're gonna make it work with the 18 or the 18T, the 1T, and we're gonna keep pushing through the night.
Tanner Holmes all over Bill Rose, racing for the top spot into turn three, dives to the inside of the racetrack. Can Holmes slide up in front of him? They'll go side by side. Bill Rose maintains the race lead. Holmes back to the inside in one and two, this time able to make the move. Bill Rose trying to cut back underneath him, but Tanner Holmes will lead the Microlite Last Chance Showdown into corner number three. We wave the green flag. Brock Zierfoss will look to the inside of Bill Rose for the second position. Can he make the pass out of turn two? They'll stay wheel to wheel down the back straightaway. Zierfoss second in the corner, number three, white flag in the air for Tanner Holmes. Adam Sobolik now all over Josh Swangler for the transfer spot, and here comes Zach Omdahl trying to seal around all of them. Omdahl one spot out, down the back straightaway, into three and four. Checkered flag waves for Tanner Holmes. Zach Omdahl from last to the final transfer spot in the final quarter, and now upside down on the front stretch. Josh Swangler caught the wall coming out of turn four.
Well, a solid B main there for us, accomplished exactly what I wanted to. And that was just to get some more laps around the racetrack and see where our car was at in clean air. I feel like, I mean, I'm not saying winning the B was a confidence booster, but it's nice just to get out front in almost like a hot lap session. I got a chance just to not see anything and work on going as fast as I could ahead of everyone. And that's big around a track, you don't know, you need that. Overall, feel like that was the best we were, better than the heat. And, you know, got through one and two well. The bottom in three and four is a little bit faster down low. One and two is a little faster up high, I think. But hopefully the surface just continues to kind of take shape here going into the A main event. We're starting deep. I think we're going to be rolling off from 21st, you know, the first transfer of the B. So we're going to need to move forward and be in a hurry. But we're going to see if they do any track prep here last minute and then kind of make our last minute changes also to the 1T to be as on it as we can. So it's time to roll for 30 laps here around the Red River Valley Speedway. They just went out and attempted to do some track prep. I don't think it's gonna do much, just a little water. They kind of had, you know, they tried to till the bottom, but it's just not a lot of material and it doesn't seem like it's going super deep. So kind of expecting a similar surface to the B to start. Hopefully it's not too slimy from the little bit of water, but main thing is just try to, you know, get going early and make as much progress while everyone's close. That's kind of the thing. Everyone's gonna be bunched up and there's very good possibility that we don't have a lot of yellows if guys just kind of spread out and get rolling. So anyway, 30 laps here on Red River Valley. Try to, you know, end strong tonight. a pretty rowdy crowd here. Where are you guys all from?
I'm from Moorhead.
Moorhead? Are you guys all from North Dakota?
Yes.
North Dakota? Yeah. North Dakota sure has a lot of great sprint car fans. What did you think of the races tonight?
I think it was awesome, and I think you kicked butt.
There you go. That's good. Yeah. All right, guys. Well, we're going to load up the Shark Racing number one tee after our weekend of racing here in North Dakota. Well, as we close out the night, as the hard charger with the World of Outlaws going plus seven from 19th to 12th, feel like the racetrack was pretty sporty.
Didn't quite get to the edge down here. 3 and 4 was a little higher, but you can see a nice wide, slick, and smooth surface.
Looking back at our race, I think that maybe if it went a little differently, we could have been inside the top 10. I just needed to be more patient in some areas, but more aggressive in others. I know that kind of contradicts each other, but just put myself in positions where I lost some momentum in the middle and towards the end. But overall, felt like we attacked well, had a good start, started passing cars, used the outside, used the bottom, used kind of a middle lane in 3 and 4 too. Like, our car felt good everywhere and was happy with the changes we made throughout the night. You know, finally found some speed there in the B. Felt like our heat race was our hot lap session just because of, you know, some of our struggles with our engine early on and not getting to hot lap and one lap and qualifying and all that. And we call those a catastrophe. With my family program, we call them catastrophes, and they happen here and there. And it's unfortunate, but it's part of the game. But my Shark Racing team, they rebounded. We kept working, had to come through the B, got through that, made some changes for the A, and was able to work forward throughout a caution-free race. I feel like we did a good job, and that's kind of how I look at the weekend as a whole. You know, of course, I wish we had a little bit better results tonight. Wish we would have, you know, capped off what could have been a solid run yesterday. But what you have to look at is the speed, and our speed was the front half of the field. We were working with the fast guys, and you know, at that point, there's just a lot of track position involved, how the race plays out, and there's so many factors in where everyone runs. So just got to keep putting yourself in those positions, and you got to be in that front half of the field to make something happen. Bobby, Tyler, and Blake, they did not give up, and they actually, it all started before the show, picking up yesterday's mess, but still they pushed through our issues early, and we still salvaged a good night. And out here on the Outlaw Tour, you're going to experience that. I've already kind of getting a little taste of everything. It's not all sunshine and rainbows. You really have to be mentally strong through the ups and the downs, and just take it all for what it is and let it make you better.
I think it's pretty obvious. These guys are the best drivers in the world.
In order to be the best, you have to race with the best, and you have to beat the best, and that's why I'm here. And I've really been enjoying these, you know, first races with Shark Racing, and can't wait to continue building on it throughout the rest of 2023. So Fargo, North Dakota, thank you. Red River Valley Speedway, I am sure I will be back, and we are now going to head west back home. Can't wait. All right, see you guys all in the next one. Deuces.